beautiful but deadly, the iconic Black Widow is a notoriously popular spider. Oftentimes, people often pitch the Black Widow spider versus the tarantula. This is because these two species of spiders are quite famous the world over. Their fame isn't the type most will crave for it is a fame of fear and fatality. While we have examined the tarantula in another video, we shall be concentrating on the Black Widow in this video. I know you're really eager for answers to questions such as, is the bite of a Black Widow truly fatal? Do female Black Widows truly eat their mates? What are the symptoms to look out for if a person is bitten by a Black Widow? To all these questions and many more, we shall be providing the answers in this video. The Black Widow primarily refers to any three species of Latrodectus. These species include the Northern Black Widow, the Eastern Black Widow, and the Western Black Widow. However, the name Black Widow is used as a generic name to refer to other spider species that belong to a family which incorporates a total of 32 spider species in all. The Black Widows have an unmistakable physical appearance. Adults are often shiny black with a bright red hourglass shape underneath their abdomen, which is often large and spherical in shape. Some may be lighter in color and even sometimes brown. The females are often the more brightly colored ones, while the males are often lighter and with red or pink spots on the upper backside of their abdomen. The distinctive features of the Black Widow extend to its difference in gender, size, and weight. The Black Widow could measure up to 1.5 inches, about 4 centimeters in length, inclusive of its leg span, and has a diameter of 0.25 inches, about 7 millimeters. The females are often twice as large as the male. These spiders can be found in temperate regions all over the world. Hence, they are often found in Africa, Asia, Australia, Southern Europe, United States, and South America. In the United States, for example, they are found in most states. This spider holds the reputation of being North America's most venomous spider. They are often found in dark or undisturbed areas such as barns, under desks and tables, basements, holes made by other animals, garages, wood piles, dense vegetation, and hollow stumps. You would be surprised to find that the lifespan of the male Black Widow is incredibly short. In the wild, the female Black Widow spider lives to be between 1 to 3 years old. The male, on the other hand, lives for just 1 to 2 months. The lifespan of a Black Widow spider begins with the female laying 200 to 750 eggs, which are wrapped in a cocoon by the female and which hatches in about 20 days later. When hatched, the hundreds of spiderlings are often whitish in color, both male and female, but as they grow older, their color gradually becomes darker until it becomes a shiny black or brown. Once hatched, the spiderlings disperse in search of their own food and territory. However, before the female can lay her eggs, she has to engage in the famous mating ritual which earned her her name. Black widows are solitary spiders. The male can easily locate the female given the chemical trail she leaves behind. Upon getting there, males will often assess the risk factor of mating with such a female. Males often prefer to mate with female Black Widows which have recently eaten. The male can tell if she has recently eaten by examining the chemical scent on her spun webs. After mating, the male Black Widow must leave quickly, or otherwise he might get eaten. The tendency of the Black Widow to engage in post-coital cannibalism, that is, the act of an animal eating its partner after having mated, is what earned this spider its dreaded name, Black Widow. While it is true that Black Widow females do eat their partner after mating, it is not very common in the wild, unlike in captivity. In the wild, there is plenty of room for the male to escape, but in a cage, escape could be difficult for the male. Most recorded sexual cannibalism attributed to the Black Widow takes place in captivity. Moreover, the Black Widow isn't the only spider that sometimes eats her mate after mating. Some other spider, such as the tarantula, is also guilty of this crime. However, we must admit that the name Black Widow is quite descriptive. The tendency of the female black widow to want to eat the male after mating is a principal reason why male black widows rarely live long and why they are often scarce to see in the wild. Other than occasionally snacking on male black widows, what else does the black widow eat? The black widow spins large webs as a snare for its prey while she dangles facing down from the web. This position makes her bright red markings visible to potential prey, which are therefore attracted by the bright color. The ensnaring web catches insects such as grasshoppers, beetles, mosquitoes, caterpillars, and flies. Once a prey is caught in the spider's web, the spider bites the prey with its venom and waits for the venom to kick in. The spider then wraps the prey in a cocoon of webs before injecting it with digestive enzymes which liquefy the prey. The spider is then able to ingest the prey by sucking it. Given the fact that the black widow is venomous, it has very few natural predators. If it bites, it is venomous. If it is eaten, it is toxic, and hence, it is safe from other animals. The brightly colored red markings are a clear sign to potential predators that the black widow is venomous and should be left alone. Most animals heed this warning and stay away from the black widow, except three: praying mantis, blue mud wasps, and alligator lizards. These three find the black widow a delicious snack that does not upset their bellies. Then, of course, man is yet another threat. Either by accident or deliberate actions, we sometimes cause the death of these spiders. The black widow spider is not considered an endangered species, as it is not listed on the International Union for Conservation of Nature's Red List. While the venom of the black spider is reputed to be 15 times more potent than that of a rattlesnake, most of the bites from this spider are rarely fatal. A single bite can cause muscle spasms, difficulty in breathing as the diaphragm is paralyzed, nausea or vomiting, sweating excessively, tremors, abdominal ache, rashes, etc. Children, the sick, and elderly persons are particularly at risk of fatality if bitten by the black widow. One reason black widow bites are rarely fatal, except if you belong to the category above, is due to the fact that this spider would rarely bite a human with a lethal dose. Its venom is often reserved for its prey, which is much smaller than humans. It is naturally reclusive and bites only when threatened. However, you should still seek medical help from professionals immediately after being bitten. It's better to be safe than sorry. The black widow is indeed the stuff of legend. It is aesthetically alluring to look at, but deadly to play with. While it sometimes lives up to its name as a sexual cannibal, this is rare in the wild, as males would often leave immediately. If you're scared of rattlesnakes, then this spider should scare you 15 times over. Hence, please be careful as you rummage through the basement, garage, undisturbed or dark places, and other such places earlier mentioned. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and check the bell notification icon so you never miss another video.